So exciting.
I mean, possibly. We don't even know if we're streaming yet. We've had this problem before where, you know, magically we've stopped streaming. Nope. Video loading.
Yep.
Video loading.
That means it's working. This is it.
Look at the other window so we can see that.
Yep.
Perfect. So far?
It's a what? Perfect so far?
My first stream is just aces. We're on time. So far, there are zero technical problems. Zero.
To be fair, we're 15 seconds into your first stream.
I didn't know...
Things are going to go south any second now.
I did not know a stream could go so perfectly.
Do you think it's because of this fantastic new computer?
I think it's because of me. I think it's because, you know, I kind of... I mean, you showed me how to use the software, but I set this up.
Absolutely.
And everything's working fine.
Yeah. Congratulations, Rich. Congratulations. I'm updating the stream now.
Can I just throw my hat in here and say that I think it's working because of me?
Absolutely.
Okay.
So I was talking with Jack about how I say testing 1, 2, 3, and Jack says testing 1, 2.
Uh-huh.
I was paying attention because I was curious what Jay did. Because I don't really think about it.
Yeah.
And Jay just says check mic.
I say check, microphone check.
Yeah.
There's no number counting at all.
There's none.
Yeah. He does it completely wrong.
Well, that's.
Or am I the only one that does it right?
You don't need... No, you just need your voice.
Yeah, it doesn't matter what you're saying. It
doesn't matter what you're saying. You could say glibbity glorp. Which I might say from now on.
Jack, there's a proper way to do things.
You're right, there's a protocol.
And everyone else is doing it wrong but me.
And actually, for mic tests, aren't you supposed to say stuff with S's?
Really?
Because then you can know whether or not you're getting some harsh
sounds. Well, I think like P's would be important.
You don't want to pop your P's.
Maybe. So, I don't know.
So instead of saying testing 1, 2, 3, I should say pesting 1, 2, 3. Pesting?
Yeah.
Pesting, pum, poo, pee?
Oh, look what someone found.
What is it? Oh. I have no idea what that is.
I don't know either.
Oh.
Have you seen this?
I was at that shoot.
Oh my god.
There's a credit to me somewhere, but I don't know if it's online.
Well, I need to stop clicking on.
Anyway, this is the first stream with my brand spanking new computer.
Mm-hmm.
My blazing fast computer, so...
Your computer that's so fast we can actually play a Far Cry game.
Yeah. To christen it, I figured we would... You know, run something a bit more modern, a bit more fancy, flashy, 3D-y, recent-y.
Yeah.
So this is Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon, starring Michael Bane.
Bean.
Michael Bean.
Is it Bean?
It's Bean.
I always thought it was Bane, because Bean sounds stupid.
Well, it's Bean.
Well, now you're making Michael Bean feel bad about his... His given last name. He can't do anything about his name.
Don't insult Michael Bean. Don't he was in Terminator.
Yeah, don't feel bad for Michael Bean. Didn't he just like marry like a Playboy bunny?
I don't know. I think he just directed a movie.
Did he?
Yeah.
Is Michael Bean was the father in Game of Thrones, right?
I don't know. I've never seen Game of Thrones.
He's the one who notoriously dies in everything that he's in.
Michael Bean? No, you're thinking of
Sean Bean.
Sean Bean, yes.
I'm thinking of Sean Bean. Who's Michael Bean?
He's Kyle Reese in Terminator.
Hicks! Motherfucking Hicks!
No.
Oh.
The guy who goes crazy in the abyss.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
You know, not a big name actor.
He's been in some big things, he's not a well known. Like, his name isn't well known. Yeah.
He's not as big as he should have been, considering the movies he's been in.
And yeah.
I've liked him in every one of those movies.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
So.
You know me by now. I don't know names or things or places, numbers or math or fractions. Come on.
Who's Laura Dern? Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, exactly. Who the fuck Krieger. Is Laura Dern? Run.
So Jay is here. So how I think this is going to work is I'm going to start game, and then Jay and Jack are going to chat about things while I get lost in the game. But that's okay.
Feel free to chime in at any point to talk about the game.
I will, but...
Because I'm sure we'll be talking about something very unimportant.
Yeah.
It's hard to concentrate on game and talk.
Oh, sure.
It is.
It's true.
So we'll see what happens.
Maybe. No vocal fool. I know plenty of things about things.
I'm going to grab a drink before I hit
Because I've seen it once, and it's terrible.
Things is the best.
Things is the worst.
I love Things.
Oh my god. Things is the worst.
I need to introduce new people to Things.
That's
the best part of watching it, just watching other people watch it.
Somebody bring up that piece of shit, Things.
Yeah.
Oh god.
Oh, here's something. Have you guys seen the new Mad Max trailer? Oh, there was a teaser trailer, and now there's a new trailer.
New trailer.
It looks so fucking awesome. It's hard for me to get it's hard for me to anticipate anything anymore. Where I'm like, oh, I can't wait for this, but it looks fucking great.
Really?
I'm so excited.
I'm excited for you. I'm excited that you're excited because I know. You, and I know that's a rare thing.
Yes.
That you are excited for a movie. And so
well, I'm excited for smaller movies, but you have a different set of expectations for a smaller, like an indie horror film
sure.
than you do for a big, like, tentpole action movie. But this Mad Max trailer is pretty great.
Oh, great.
Yeah, large movies, it's rare for me to get excited about anymore.
Oh, Rich, they all commented WAXD?
I'm using some kind of fancy ass pad. I'm not using the regular keyboard. What am I using here? It's called the Wolf King. I know it's got some kind of goofy ass name, but the keys are laid out a bit more like a grid pattern.
It's very strange. It's
and
like
I don't like scrunching my fucking thumb up to hit that S key for down.
Yeah.
That's just fucking uncomfortable. Yeah. I like just evenly spaced your fingers.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is more comfortable to me.
It makes sense, but picture like a circle, and then all the keys of a normal keyboard are kind of arranged weird.
Yeah.
Grid on
yeah.
the circle.
It's weird.
So it's weird, but, you know. And no, Rich, because Rich is playing this, he's using a mouse and keyboard, not a gamepad.
And I'm still lounging on the goddamn couch.
And he's still on the couch. No, he's not using a trackpad because we're using Rich's computer and not mine anymore. This is going to be, everyone is going to love this. Because you're using the things you're supposed to use.
Earth. We'll see how good I do. I might be distracted talking with you guys.
Sure.
So.
Oh, man, look at that. Look
you
at
can
that.
Hear, like, the voiceover. The end of the 20th century.
That's beautiful.
Oh, there's a good shot coming up, sir.
Wait for it.
This is the best thing ever.
Oh, that's pretty good. So it's a post-apocalyptic game.
Mm. Yes. I think in the trailer they call it the apocalypse of the apocalypse.
Beautiful. Oh, they're asking you to turn on subtitles.
Oh, that would be a good idea.
Yeah.
I'll do it when I can skip the cutscene. When I can't, right after the cutscene, because I'm not skipping cutscene.
Skip the cutscene.
No! I refuse. This is the first time I've played this. I put off because I knew I was going to stream it. So
sure, sure.
This yeah. is my first time with the game.
That's right, Lucky Strike, set in 2007.
Yes.
I started this once just to see how it would run, and it ran really nice.
Well, yeah, you got the gaming machine. Just looking at that, I'm intimidated.
They got Terminator 1 music going, kind of a doo-doo-doo.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, look at those cybernetic enhancements. This is kind of beautiful.
This is fucking awesome.
Yeah. This is kind of beautiful.
Sergeant Rex Power Colt.
Of course. Cyber Commando. Of course. And yes, everyone in the chat, I did hear about the new difficulty settings for Alien Isolation. They've added two new difficulty settings, both harder than hard.
Oh.
So now everyone who played it on hard said
they weren't playing it right.
So now the game's twice as tedious.
But also people weren't playing it right now because they weren't playing it on hard.
Yeah.
So they all have to replay the game in order to play it right.
Fuck that game.
But you know what? Fuck that game. It's really true. Michael Bean. It's weird.
Michael Bean.
Bean.
Bean. Bean.
Bean.
Bean.
This isn't difficult, people.
It's really not.
It's weird the way they do the screen on the cutscenes here.
Oh, it's a tiny screen?
Yeah, yeah, but it's like up and tiny. It's not centered and tiny. It's really weird.
You know, I guess I never thought about that, but that is weird. You're right. Maybe I think it's supposed to like be comic book panel-y.
Maybe? I don't know.
Maybe.
Alright.
Oh, the actual game.
Wait, I'm looking for, yeah, I'm looking for...
Oh, that's right.
Subtitles. Where would that be? I guess it'd be an audio, right? Nope.
Gameplay?
Chat, tell me where subtitles be. Yar. Where they, where be thar subtitle yos?
I'm sorry, but Rich has been taken over by a pirate.
No.
Video.
Okay. No. Maybe,
oh
but
my
I don't.
God. Your overall quality is set on ultra?
Yes!
Jesus Christ, Rich! Your new computer is awesome. It says probably in audio, but I guess.
Someone's saying it's in video.
Oh. Okay. Go in video then.
It won't let me. There, right. I had to escape. Okay. Oh, there we go.
Subtitles. I guess that makes sense.
Yeah.
There we go.
In France.
There we go.
Don't do that.
I won't. Jerk.
Oh, also, you didn't hit apply.
Yeah, okay. There you
go. All right. Back to it.
Why isn't the Miami Connection song playing, Rich?
It plays it.
Sorry.
It should play through the whole game.
It does. It should. You're right.
Only through the elimination of violence can we achieve world peace.
Now, excuse me while I cut this man's head.
I need to rewatch that. I haven't watched it since we did it for Best of the Worst.
Right.
I need to watch that movie again. I know it was on Netflix for a while. I don't know if it still is. If it is, everyone in the chat should watch Miami Connection.
Yes. Even if it's not, everyone in the chat should watch Miami Connection.
You should seek it out, yeah, definitely.
This looks great. Congratulations,
man. I love it. I love the Terminator style laser bullets, too.
Yeah. So what is this mission here?
You know what, I'm kind of half paying attention.
Oh, okay.
I'll probably restart later and just play it from scratch.
Okay.
For now, I think I'm just gonna... Oh, what happened? Oh.
Oh, cutscene.
Plot. For now, yeah, I think I'm just gonna play it and have fun and whatever.
Yeah. Let's show them how Psycho Commandos get it done. My stream quality is worse than what Rich is seeing for once. That's true. That's true. We are only streaming, yeah, just to make sure you guys get, you know, good stream, we are only streaming in 720. Which, I know.
Only
in 720. We'll work on it.
What is this, 1984?
I think in 1984 you couldn't stream at all.
Oh, this music's awesome.
That's the joke. Jay Bowman's beard. Yes, I've seen Prisoners of the Lost Universe. I cosplayed as Dan Roebuck from Prisoners of the Lost Universe in one of our early Half of the Bag episodes, if you haven't seen it. And I interviewed what's-his-face, the lead actor from Battlestar Galactica. What's his name?
James Olmos?
No, the original Battlestar. Because he was in Prisoners of the Lost Universe. And so I interviewed him in cosplay as his character.
Oh.
But he had no idea.
Oh.
And then once he figured it out, he realized we were kind of being smart asses.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Richard Hatch, that was his name, yeah.
Richard Hatch. Did you skip the tutorial?
Yeah, I don't know if I can. I think the tutorial was done for comedy.
Oh, sure.
Because he's saying things like, "God damn it, why can't I shoot things already?"
Ah, I gotcha.
Yeah.
Nice. As he should be.
What the fuck? We have a subscriber, Jack. I can't read that from here, so...
you know who it was? Cameron Mitchell.
Ah, sweet name!
Cameron Mitchell, thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it.
Tip, moving allows you to go in many exciting directions.
Also, Cameron Mitchell, make sure you close that door.
Close that fucking door.
Gotta close the door.
Oh, shit, that's stupid. I gotta turn on auto run.
Would you close the fucking door?
Lucky Strike says, I rewatched an early episode of The Bag and realized Jack was in an episode.
It's true, Jack was the mailman.
Yeah.
You're the mailman twice, but it's like 3 years apart from when you show up as the mailman again.
No, I never came back as the mailman.
Oh no, your body does.
Oh, my body?
Yeah, yeah, that's right. Your body that's been hacked to pieces shows up. We did shoot, like, your head on the ground. I remember that. And we didn't end up using it for some reason. Maybe we couldn't get the effect to work. I don't even remember.
Mm-hmm. Yep. It's true. Also, you know, here's a little behind-the-scenes tidbits about the very first Half in the Bag episode.
Oh, yeah.
I was called in for a very special assignment on the very first Half in the Bag episode.
I don't remember this.
Do you remember what my special assignment was?
No.
In true Jay and Mike fashion, both of them had to be on camera at the same time,
mm-hmm.
So I had to dolly the camera.
Oh, that's right. For the end when George Lucas comes in, right?
Yeah, yep.
That's right.
For when George Lucas, Tim, and...
and his henchmen.
And his henchmen.
Yeah.
When they come in, you, Mike, and Rich were all on camera.
Yes, so he needed somebody to move the camera. I forgot about that.
Is that another? Oh, that is. The grinding of my sack.
My sack is one word?
Mysick. The grinding of mysick. Thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it. Oh my lord, and grumpy kitten. Thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it. Grumpy a kitten. Yeah, usually in the early Half in the Bag episodes, if you see all three of them on camera at a time and the camera moves,
yeah.
that's me. Very exciting.
If I remember right, we shot the skit stuff for episodes 1 and 2, like on the same day.
Possibly.
Do you remember that?
What was the skit for day 2?
That was when the masseuse comes over and Plinkett tries to lay on the yes. ironing board.
Yes.
I want to say we shot those at the same time.
You shot them, or did you shoot that and Mailman Tommy at the same time?
No, Mailman Tommy was later, because that was the Transformers episode. That was, I don't even remember what number episode that was, 7, 8, something like that.
Okay.
That was a while later.
Okay. But then yes, you are correct. You shot those skits at the same time.
Yeah.
And I remember Chelsea.
Yes.
Was very confused as to what you were doing.
Yeah. As most people are that aren't around us on a regular basis. Wait, what are you doing? What is this?
So what do I need to? What, where am I? Ooh, yes, OctoJ, you're right. I was also one of the Comedy Bar patrons when Jillian was on After
the Bag. Oh, yeah. I remember, I don't even remember if any of it's in the episode, but I remember we shot some stuff where you were actually talking more. Like,
yeah.
You kept leaning over to us and making comments. I don't even remember what ended up in the episode. What?
Nothing. I can't stop to explain. You're in the middle of things.
We're in the middle of things. Yeah, we shot because both Jillian and I are big improvisers.
Mm-hmm.
We shot a ton with me and Jillian.
Yeah.
It's all gone now.
That's what happens with improv.
Yep. All the it was gold, I'm sure. It was nothing but gold.
I want to say some of it was funny. I just don't remember what it was anymore. I just know we shot a lot.
Oh, I'm sure. I'm absolutely sure. And it doesn't matter because it was super fun. I wanted, like, Jillian, you know, you told her to be a really bad stand-up, and all she did was give the setups to jokes. She would never tell me punchlines.
My favorite, I think this is on the outtakes on the archive DVD, is when she's doing her stand-up, she just goes, "Hey, you guys remember dicks?" And that was her joke. Do you guys remember dicks?
Yes. Ah, Jillian. She's great.
What did stay in the episode, though, is her talking about teleporting inside her boombox. Do you remember that?
No.
She's like, I was in the middle of getting intimate, and then, bam, I teleported inside my jam box. Like, it's not a joke. I don't even know what it is, but it's funny.
Thank you, OctoJ, for reminding me. No, I didn't. I was so overcome by how great Far Cry looks. I forgot to tweet.
Oh.
That's all right. I'm tweeting now. I'm tweeting it live. So for everyone who doesn't follow us on Twitch, are you dying?
I think so, yep. I fucked up.
Is this a no death run?
No.
Okay, I've now tweeted. It's just so weird. Like, I came to the studio today and, like,
I'm doing awful.
I didn't bring my computer. Like, it's so weird.
You just showed up.
I just showed up. It was great. I'm very excited about this in the future. Oh, they're saying that pistol is supposed to be like a RoboCop pistol. Yeah, it kind of looks a little RoboCop-y.
Yeah, well, thanks, futury.
Well, it is in the year 2007, so.
What's next year? What futuristic film happened in 2015?
Back to the Future 2.
Back to the Future 2. Mm-hmm. That's a good one. That's a good one.
I don't think we're going to have flying cars by next year.
Somebody did do a fake thing for hoverboards.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, that was a while ago. I remember seeing that.
Oh, shit.
But actually, then, they came out with a quasi-real one. You need, like, a special track.
I heard about that, yeah.
Yeah. The fake video was fun. Funny or Die.
Was it Funny or Die?
That was
Funny. Oh, okay. I just remember reading the comments where people were like, this is obviously fake. And you're like, well, yeah, obviously. But then again, there were people that felt the need to point out that the Rich's reaction to the Star Wars trailer was fake.
I still don't know about that.
Obviously, that was real.
I mean, it could have been fake.
This is clearly fake.
Clearly.
You are a genius.
Is the inevitable space cop game going to be like this? Exactly. This, in fact, is the space cop game. Yeah. Far Cry Space Cop.
The set design is very similar to a lot of the stuff we've done in Space Cop, too. Yeah. This looks a lot like Space Cop.
So all you need to do is make the character move a little slower and give him a much bigger gun. And it's basically Space Cop, right? I don't know if we're gonna beat this tonight. I don't know how long it takes to beat it.
I don't know how long it is.
Oh, okay. Is this a real game? Ooh, an emote of Swag Rich. That's a funny one. Maybe we can get that as an emote, yeah.
Swag Rich?
From your t-shirt video. Rich, like.
Oh, yeah.
Tweeting, yep.
I never think of it as being like swag rich because that's just how rich always is.
Right.
So, I don't even notice anymore.
If anything, someone being swag is someone being like rich.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Lucky Strikes, that's a good question. Rich, why do you need to reload a laser?
That's goofy.
That's goofy. Damn it. It's a fine question. Oh, you're right. Octojay's right. Needs new batteries. You're not...
Oh.
Guns. Bullets. You're reloading batteries.
God, it's got cheesy one-liners.
Yeah. It's beautiful.
All right, I'm doing terrible.
Do you have the shotgun? They're saying switch to shotgun. It's much cooler.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Is that not the normal switch weapons button for this? Are you?
I don't know. And first of all, if you had a shotgun, I mean, always go shotgun in any game.
In any shooter,
you go with shotgun.
No.
That's my go-to in any game.
No, there's some effective machine guns, Jack.
Oh, sure.
I'm sorry.
It's just way more fun with shotgun.
Oh, why is throw wheel the grenade button and not the change weapon button? That is dumb.
Only if only there was a way you could change it. Wait a minute.
Is there a select weapon though? A previous and next. Oh, that's so weird. I'm gonna leave it kind of as it is for now.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Rich is using a mouse and keyboard. Rich always uses a mouse and keyboard. It's me.
It's what you're supposed to do.
It's
what you're supposed to do.
It's the only way to do this.
You are required by law to do it that way, and Jack, you are breaking the law.
I'm breaking the law. Oh my god. Octojay, that would be hilarious if Rich was playing this like on a touch screen. What? Like aiming with a touch screen?
What? Okay, now the button I put select weapon is throwing grenades. I don't understand you, game.
Oh, someone's saying there wasn't an email notification.
Oh, I didn't get a fly.
From
it's
Twitch
big on that.
About the stream.
There wasn't.
That's what someone's saying.
Oh.
I don't know why that
this
would
be. This shotgun sucks!
That might be in your settings. You might need to double check that in your settings you get email notifications from us.
Mm.
It could be a weird thing with Twitch. I don't know.
Twitch glitch?
You guys killed me with your awful shotgun advice.
Are they trolling?
I think so.
Oh, no.
After performing a blade takedown, you can shuriken a nearby enemy.
Shotties are for close range. Of course they are.
That's I shot him 8 times in close range. He did not die.
School's out forever.
Oh, they're saying that was actually a sniper rifle, the thing you used.
Oh, was it?
Yeah. No, so, in fact, that was the opposite of a shotgun.
What? Oh, there we go. That looks like a regular
shotgun. Oh, my God, that's awesome. That's badass.
That's cool.
Michael Biehn?
Yeah.
That's alien style. Right there, he had that shotgun.
Nice.
Right, did I get spotted? Yeah, I did.
All right.
Yeah, okay, that shotgun's not bad. That's not a bad shot. Where am I going to get three guys out?
Oh, Dick Neutral is saying he didn't get the notification either. Hold on, let me double check on my end that that we're set up to notify people. Thank you for letting me.
I saw, someone said they haven't gotten email notifications in a while for prereq stuff.
Well.
Everything is fucked.
Everything's ruined, I'm sorry.
Which one was the sniper rifle? Sense. Yeah, that's definitely a sniper rifle. Yep, I figured that out. Everything's working now.
Notifications.
Someone else is saying No email tonight. Have every other time.
Oh.
So I don't know.
I don't know either. I'm looking at it. I don't know where to exactly look for this.
Someone's saying it has to do with Twitch because they're not getting other notifications from other streams.
Oh, that could be.
So
that could be. Twitch is still. I mean, we need to remember that Twitch is still a relatively young web service.
Is it?
It is. Mm. And then, you know, they just, of course, got bought by Amazon, but, you know, the infrastructure hasn't changed yet, so they're still working on it, and of course they're growing exponentially.
Yeah.
Everyone's Twitch streaming now, and so it's just like, we have to deal with some of these glitches.
Twitch glitch?
The old Twitch glitch. Jack, tell Rich to use his mini-map. He always has bad guys shooting at him nearby and doesn't notice. Rich?
Okay.
Use your minimap. You know, Zach Peterson, you're right. I did promise technical difficulties tonight, but
everything went swimmingly.
Everything went really great.
I could not
imagine. So you failed at having no difficulties.
I'm really I guess I'm sorry. But, you know, this is good. You know, I think we're doing a good thing. It seems to be working. What am I talking out of my ass about? Jack?
What?
Oh, they said listen to Jack talking out of his ass but pretending like he knows what he's saying. First of all, that's all the time.
I was going to say, they could just copy-paste that at any point during the stream.
This is... Have you guys not been paying attention to me?
Oh, I saw someone, I think it's past it now, they asked why I made peanut butter cookies when I know Rich is allergic. Because I didn't make them for them. I made them for my family. I just brought extra cookies because they were burnt.
I thought you were just being a jerk. Wait.
No, they were cookies that didn't turn out so well. They were for my family for Thanksgiving.
And when he ruined them and they weren't good enough for his family.
Then I gave my scraps to Jack and yeah.
Objective complete. Briar Patch, why didn't you tell us this was Omega Force?
They were Omega Force. No. It was a last-minute thing. JK.
Oh my God! People are shocked that I have a family. I'm pretty sure everybody does to some extent. Yeah. Otherwise, you would not exist.
That's the thing. That's the thing.
Yeah.
All right. Where am I going?
Where are you going?
I don't know.
Okay.
I never played this game before. I don't know where I'm going.
Great. Do it.
I see an arrow thing down here, so I can go down, I guess, in the building-like area?
Uh-huh.
If I can find an entrance?
Hey, Harry Potter does, too, have a family. They just keep him in a cupboard.
Is that a thing?
Where are they?
Harry Potter? They keep him in a cupboard? What?
Because he, you know, has both of his. Spoiler alert for the Harry Potter series.
I've seen them all. Here's my thing with the Harry. I've never read the books, but my thing with the movies is,
yeah.
I saw all of them in the theater when they came out.
Okay.
Not like a big fan or anything. I just went and saw them because they were movies.
Sure.
And every time they ended, I'd say that was entertaining.
Mm-hmm.
And then the next day, I completely forgot everything that happened. Those movies are like in one ear out the other for me.
That seems.
Except for the one. With the werewolf, the Gary Oldman one with the werewolf, because that was made by a very talented filmmaker. The other ones are just kind of bland. But I don't even remember anything about him being in a cupboard. I don't remember any of that.
Do you remember in the first Harry Potter movie, it's his aunt and uncle.
Yeah.
Who are, by the way, his family. And he lives under the stairs. They keep him in the cupboard under.
Oh, okay. Actually, I don't know if I did see the first one. I don't know if I ever saw that one.
I think after that one, they gave him a room.
Okay.
But he starts living under the stairs.
Okay.
Because he's an embarrassment to his family.
That should not have taken three fucking hits. I'm sorry. The shotgun at close range.
Well, they're wearing armor. Hold Q to heal.
I just wanted to see how long that would take with him shooting at me. Okay. Close range, the shotgun, the close range weapon. He's not dying.
Yeah, you know, I've the Harry Potter movies. They're all fine.
Yeah, they're okay.
I remember my wife was a big fan of the books. Is a big fan of the books. Really loved the books. So, you know, of course we went to see all the movies and all, and there was one of the Harry Potter movies that ended with Harry Potter, like, it was a freeze frame of him on his flying broom, and he's just so happy.
Yeah.
And my wife turns to me, and she goes, that's kind of cheesy, don't you think? And I'm like, you mean the movie about...
The little boy wizard?
The little boy wizard flies on a broom. You think that ended a little too cheesy? That actually might have been the end of the werewolf one. Where it ended maybe in a cheesy note. I forget which
No, one. It wouldn't, because that one was pretty dark. Yeah. I don't think it would end like that.
One of them ended on a very chipper note. Everyone okay. was happy, and it was a freeze frame.
It's probably one of the first two, then, I would say.
Maybe the second one, yeah. Jay has seen the new Mad Max trailer.
Yes. It looks so fucking awesome.
half paying attention. Uh-huh. Got the, you know, I'm missing a ton of things.
Yeah, absolutely. This is the thing, Rich.
I'm ripping their hearts out. I don't know what I do with the hearts.
Okay.
But that's okay.
You got one cyber
art. Oh, people are saying it was the werewolf one that ended with the cheesy freeze frame.
Yeah.
Interesting.
And so, yes, that was a dark movie, but it's still a kid's movie. It's still a movie about a little boy wizard. You know, they eat chocolate frogs and cast spells with a little wand. They can be as cheesy as they want. Oh, thank you, Freaky. I got his merch today. It arrived in the mail.
Oh.
That's right.
Well, thank you for purchasing. Thank you for supporting us.
And for those who don't know, there's new merchandise. T-shirt.
Been hard at work packaging stuff all day. That's what we did all day, was processing orders and packaging. Because in addition to creating the videos that we make, editing the videos that we make, updating the website, building sets, we also package and send out all of our products ourselves. So, we keep busy.
That's good. This is a good thing. Yeah, and the new t-shirts, by the way. Feel fantastic.
Yeah, they're nice. They're nice shirts. We met with the company that made them before we decided to order them, and looked at the different styles of shirts they had, and figured out what we thought would be the most comfortable. Quality control. That's what we were about with getting these t-shirts. They're not cheapo crap t-shirts.
No, they're very nice.
They're good shirts.
I want one. They won't let me have one. Yeah.
Probably not until after this first one.
Well, yeah, exactly. We have a limited run at the moment. no, Liz, 6005. Our hands did not touch the merchandise. We use like those grabber things that old people use, so we don't physically touch them.
Right. Because they don't want you harvesting their DNA. Which may or may not be on that.
We're wearing hazmat suits.
Oh, fuck. Yeah. Somebody must have hit me with a grenade or something. I got blowed up.
Oh, no. I'm so sorry.
I'm assuming there's a melee button of some sort that I don't know about.
If only there was a way you could find out.
I'm checking that right now, Jack. Checking that out right
I'm
now.
I'm sorry. I know. You're just talking through it. And I like that. I like that you're talking through it. I was being an asshole, and I apologize.
Yeah, there is. F. I don't like that key.
Gay for Jade, you're getting your shirt sometime after you've ordered and paid for it. I don't know. Do you guys like send out tracking numbers or anything? Or?
I honestly, I don't deal with that aspect of it, so I don't know.
Yeah.
That's not my department.
It's coming. Or maybe it's not. I don't know. Rich Evans babyface t-shirt. Listen, I don't know if it's possible, right? That's the question, is whether or not you can get the face on a shirt.
Mm.
You mean just for the, because of the colors and whatnot?
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know. We'd have to look into it.
Well, you should combine it with the Dick the Birthday Boy.
Yeah. Yeah, because people have asked about Dick the Birthday Boy shirts.
But would people want a Dick the Birthday Boy shirt with anything else on it, I guess.
I'd feel weird selling a shirt that just says that and that blocky text. Like, that's kind of lame. maybe that's what people would want. I don't know.
You would have to put some sort of, like, Red Letter Media logo somewhere small on it.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. We're sticking with the simple ones right now just because we wanted to kind of ease into this. Yeah. So we'll see.
Don't. Sorry.
A fuck you, it's January t-shirt. yeah. Cuss words, you know.
That's a tricky thing with t-shirts having swear words on them.
Sure. You know. And you guys have so many memorable catchphrases.
Mm-hmm.
Like, hey, you. That's one of my favorites.
No. Also every time we say no, that's a big one.
No.
No.
When you say shut up, that's a really good catchphrase.
So. We just say that to you, though. That's not a catchphrase we do on the shows.
I just assume, because you say it to me so often.
I'm baffled by my keyboard.
That's right. Oh, I see people doing that's right, Jay. Yeah, I guess that's a pretty common one.
Yeah.
I don't know. We don't want to go overboard with the shirts. People were asking for shirts, so we made some shirts, but we don't want to go crazy. We'll see.
I don't know, Jay. We'll see is a pretty big commitment. Dick the Birthday Boy has a good question. Where do I make a note if I want items signed when I order?
There should be like a leave a comment field somewhere on the order form.
Through PayPal?
It's through PayPal.
Nobody yet has asked for a signed t-shirt?
No one has asked for a signed t-shirt. It might be tricky because they're dark.
Yeah.
So, I mean, we have some like silver pens and stuff, but I don't know how it would look on a shirt.
Yeah, when you pay via PayPal, there's usually
there should be just a look, leave a note, leave a comment, something like that.
Yep.
Or if that doesn't work, if you can't find it, or if ordering through...
I can't change that, too. That was dumb. There we go.
Or if it's maybe... Because I know ordering through Bandcamp, I think it still processes through PayPal. Mm-hmm. But if nothing else, just send us an email.
Mm-hmm.
Saying your name and your order number. Can you guys sign this? Contact at redlettermedia.com.
Sure. Great.
So, there.
Yeah, so you could have gotten your DVD signed. The posters, we sign a lot of posters.
Mm-hmm.
The DVDs we sign.
The dividas.
Also the posters.
That's about all we got.
All right. I just killed some guys good.
Yeah?
And quiet.
Ooh. I love the look of this game.
Yeah.
All the purples and greens. This is so... I know they're doing it to be, like, kitschy, but it just looks neat.
Yeah, no, I like that. I like, bright, vivid colors like that.
Yeah. And it just makes everything stand out really nice. Like, mm-hmm. It's just good enemy design, you know?
Yeah, this is a neat-looking game. Detecting heavily armored cyber soldiers. Use heavy ordnance. Rich, is your character a human?
cyborg.
It is a cyborg, okay. I didn't know if it was like a human with a robotic arm or something.
They above me?
Oh my god, if you could get Worf's purple space bazooka in this. I know you were saying you want a Worf purple space bazooka t-shirt, but I want the
purple
space bazooka in the game. You probably couldn't do the t-shirt because, you know, Worf isn't...
It's not our character.
Yeah, you should get the hell out of there. Me, I should. Mysack, grinding of Mysack, asks a question that I'm going to answer because it seems like we ran out of stuff to talk about in general. He would like to know, in a fictional fight, who would win? Where did it go? What am I saying?
Zelda versus Mario.
Zelda versus Mario.
What the fuck?
You know, it depends on which Zelda you're talking about. Is it normal Zelda, in which case she's just a princess, like, doesn't have much going for her. The Zelda in Smash Brothers has some superpowers. Could it be possible that you meant Link?
Oh yeah.
Versus
when I was a kid, I always thought that the main character was Zelda.
Yeah.
Because I didn't play that game, but my brother did.
Real quick, D Duval 59, sorry, D Duval 59. Thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it. So I guess, you know, maybe Mario wouldn't fight her because in general he saves princesses.
Mm-hmm.
But. Yeah, oh yeah, I thought you meant Link. In which case, I think Link, because he has a sword and a bow and arrow.
Hand to hand. No weapons. No items.
No weapons, no items.
Yes.
Oh.
Power-ups, no items, no weapons.
Here's a question, though. What are they fighting about?
Nobody gives a shit about those. It's just a dorky thing
to talk about. I would think the motivation of the fight would have an influence on who is more, you know, engaged in wanting to win.
Sure.
I think this is an important question.
Okay. If
Bowser and Ganon have banded together and stolen both princesses. But, obviously, Link and Mario could fight them individually, so they need to get rid of them. And so they say, okay, whoever wins the fight...
We won't kill your princess.
We won't kill your princess. You get your princess back.
Okay.
So that, you know, that's so they have equal stakes.
Okay.
In the fight. And
well, Mario's from. I don't think this is in the games, but I know it's in the movie.
Yeah.
They're from Brooklyn, right?
Yeah, he's a plumber from Brooklyn.
Okay. Is that in the original games? Is there any mention of that, or is that just in the movie?
Yeah, he goes through a secret portal.
Okay. I don't remember
that. Might be mentioned in the manual.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna say Mario then, because he grew up in Brooklyn. Link grew up in a little fantasy world with elves and shit. And fairies and...
Okay. You know, I'll buy that. And also, like, depending on which Link... Because most of the time, Link is a child.
Oh, well, that changes everything.
And
yeah,
Mario's
definitely.
Full-grown man from Brooklyn.
Yeah. He'll beat that little kid's ass.
Exactly. So, yes. Mario wins in the fight. Unless you're talking about, like, cool teenage Link, you know, from, like, Skyward Sword or that. And in which case, he might have a chance. But still, like, yeah, Mario from Brooklyn.
Mm-hmm.
Because also, Mario from Brooklyn would do some dirty shit.
Yes.
You know.
That's true.
He jumps on people's heads.
He's jumping.
Crying out
loud. The man can break bricks with his head. He doesn't give a shit.
He's not afraid to mess things up with a hammer either.
This is what I'm saying.
Mm.
Well, you know,
this is the man who single-handedly took down an 800-pound gorilla. Barehanded.
And after that, he fought a fucking dinosaur. You know. Of course, if they have weapons. I don't care if Mario gets the mushroom, you know, the super mushroom, or the fire flower.
Oh, Link has a sword.
Link has a sword.
And a shield.
And a shield.
And bombs and a bow and arrow. He's going to win if they have items.
Yes.
But no items, it's Mario.
I'm glad we worked this out.
How did I miss every single shot? That's a ROM drive. Oh, fuck.
Oh, Dick the Birthday Boy says he just ordered shirt, DVD, Space Cop poster. Nowhere to put in a note for signed items.
There should be. But I don't know. If that's the case, then just send us an email.
Yep. Yeah. Oh, here's a really good fan fiction important question.
Okay.
Who would win in a fight? Samurai Cop. Or Len Kapuscinski.
Ooh. Len Kapuscinski.
You think Len?
Yeah.
Why is that?
Because Samurai Cop's kind of stupid.
We're not talking Matt Hannon.
Yeah.
We're talking...
Well, Matt Hannon is not stupid. The character of Samurai Cop is he's a little cocky.
Yeah.
He's not as bright as he thinks he is.
But he trained with the
Masters. He trained with the Masters in Japan.
Len Kapuscinski, though, is a legit champion, multi-degree black belt with weapons training.
I don't know.
He seems very enthusiastic.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Like, I honestly don't know who would win.
I follow Len on Twitter, and he just won another, like, major... He just won more major awards. Like,
oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
So, weapons. Do they have weapons? Because Samurai Cop has a gun.
And a samurai sword. Kind of. Yeah, I would say no weapons. I think I'm gonna go with Len.
I gotta give it to Len.
Yeah.
I agree.
He wasn't trained by the Masters in Japan, but he's pretty good.
Yeah, and you know, Samurai Cop doesn't seem to keep training. You know, like, he's not training anywhere in the movie.
That's because he thinks he's the shit. He doesn't think he needs to. Right. Samurai Cop's a little too cocky.
Whereas Len is still in it.
Mm-hmm.
Probably multi times a week.
Yeah. You know. Yeah.
Absolutely. That's right, John Kilo. Len Kapuscinski trained with the Masters in Murph. I'm reversing the cold polarity. Almost there.
The Masters in PetSmart. Len doesn't work at PetSmart, by the way. I don't think we ever cleared that up in our interview or anything we've done, but he does not work at PetSmart.
No. He just has dogs.
Is that what it was?
We asked him about that. Yeah,
okay. I know we asked him, but I couldn't remember. Okay.
So he just knows the people at PetSmart. Oh, did I miss a sub? Rich, you gotta tell me when you hear the what the fuck.
I didn't hear it.
I don't see a sub.
I subbed.
A fake sub?
So saying, Jack, you missed. I think I missed a sub. I don't believe I did. Hold on, I'm looking back in the chat. The enemies are targeting Lieutenant Brown. Alert, Lieutenant Brown is taking fire. Looking back. I don't see a sub. You might be lying to me. Ooh, whose hair is more righteous, Len Kapuscinski or Matt Hannon?
I gotta go to Matt Hannon.
Yeah, Matt's got it.
Wig or no wig?
Mm-hmm. Oh, well, I'm sorry, Biznet. Biznet! Thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it. I'm looking back here. I don't see it. It might have glitched out for me. Twitch glitch.
Ooh, Crazy Fat Ethel versus Divine. Do you know who Divine is?
Yeah, from John Waters.
From John Waters movies.
Crazy Fat Ethel.
Well, if we're going Divine and Pink Flamingos, I'm gonna go with Divine, because she's just a complete psychopath. I mean, Crazy Fat Ethel is a little older, a little slower. Divine will just lose her shit and go off, so.
Was she homicidal?
Divine?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Pink Flamingos?
You've never seen Pink Flamingos?
A long time ago.
Okay. Yeah, yeah. It's a family of homicidal characters.
All I remember is the ending.
Yeah, everybody knows the ending. Everybody knows that. There's actually, there's a documentary, I think it's on Netflix now, called I Am Divine. All about Divine. That's definitely worth checking out if you're a fan of John Waters and Divine.
I hear about a lot of good documentaries these days.
That's because that's where it's at. There's lots of good documentaries. And there's so many about such specific things now. Yeah. Like very, like I love John Waters, I love Divine. Like, here's a documentary specifically for me. You know?
Oh, sure.
There's so many.
Well,
it's great.
There's so many avenues for distribution now.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's a big part of it. Like, yeah, I mean, there we had two documentaries about VHS last year.
Yeah.
Like, it's a great time to be alive.
Last year I saw a really great documentary on the wah pedal.
Oh, really?
And it was a Vimeo exclusive, and it was made by a company that makes wah pedals. And
stuff. Oh, okay.
It was a little propaganda, but, like, never did they once, like, say, like, and now, you know, featuring the new, it was literally just about, like, the history and musicians who have used a wah pedal and why. And,
oh, okay.
Like, they talked to the guy who played, you know, the Shaft theme song.
Yeah.
Which is, and, like, they have an extended interview with that guy, and he was really pissed because he didn't get to play any notes. He's literally just...
He's just... okay.
He was really upset with Isaac Hayes because Isaac's like, no, do that for 15 minutes.
Oh, that's funny.
So it was like a really fascinating documentary just about the wah pedal.
Yeah. Like, there's a documentary about the font Helvetica. Like, there's so many specific documentaries.
Fuck yeah, there is.
I haven't seen it. I've been meaning to see it.
Oh, it's fun.
I've heard it's good.
It's fun.
I saw someone a little while ago asked if I would ever make a documentary. We kind of made a documentary with How Not to Make a Movie, which is one of the things we've done that I'm most proud of, actually. But I do have a couple ideas for documentaries, so maybe one of these days I can find the time to focus on them. Because I like documentaries. I like that format, and I like editing that format. Because you're sort of discovering what the movie is as you're putting it together.
Yeah,
I like that. Peter Dinklage versus Divine. I've got to go with Divine. I think most people versus Divine, I would go with Divine.
Oh, well, AIDS Moby, thank you for subscribing. Even though you're a bit of an asshat, we
You know, they did that just to see.
Just to see if I would say thank you.
Yeah.
And I do. I still appreciate it. You're helping support the stream.
Yeah.
You know, if you would like, if calling me a name makes you support the stream, then, you know, do what you gotta do.
It's your life, man.
No, OctoJ, you don't need to ban that. That's fine.
OctoJ's so confused.
I know. Feel free to insult him, though, Jay.
Yeah, OctoJ, you could make fun of him a little bit.
Len versus Divine. Divine! If we're talking Divine in either Pink Flamingos or Female Trouble, definitely Divine.
That's crazy talk. That really is crazy talk.
Right?
No, because Divine will fight dirty. Len will try and be, like, respectful and
sure.
You know, he'll
sure.
Treat it like a legitimate fight, and Divine will do something nefarious. Badler, yeah, our DVDs are region-free.
That's good. That's smart.
Except for yours.
Yeah, if you order them, they will have a region lock on them.
Unless you're from Australia.
One of the other countries. Unless you're from one of the other countries.
Yeah.
Your region.
It's region free for America.
Oh, I'm so happy to see
so many countries. You know, you're being too specific, Jack. Single point of the joke.
So happy.
Sound like a joke.
Oh. I'm so happy to see so many people talking about Divine. This is great. I don't know if anybody cared. I was thinking about, I posted something on Twitter the other day. I posted a clip from Desperate Living, John Waters movie. I've been thinking about John Waters a lot lately. I need to go back and rewatch some of his movies. I own them all. I love John Waters, but I haven't watched any in a while.
looking at two genuine
wars. I think the last John Waters movie I saw was Pecker.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like Pecker.
It's fine.
I haven't seen it in a while.
It's fine. I'm not a huge John Waters.
I like his older movies. Like, it's weird because he's had the same style of writing through his entire career. It's just everybody yelling. But technically he's gotten better, which makes the movies less interesting. When you have professional actors saying that dialogue, it's not as funny as if you have, like, Divine or Edith Massey or the characters that were in his older movies saying it.
Okay.
It makes them feel more surreal than having, like, professional people, like a professional looking movie and real actors saying those lines. Sure. It's not as interesting.
I think that's a really fair point.
Yeah. Because I know some people don't some people don't like Pecker, don't like Cecil B. DeMented, and I think if those movies were made 30 years earlier, and, you know, with his friends as the actors, there'd be a more amateur quality that makes them better.
Okay.
If that makes sense. It's hard, his movies are so hard to explain, like, why they work, but...
I like it. Oh, and Dick the Birthday Boy, yes, we see that you sent specific instructions. For what to be signed by who?
Oh, okay.
We are on it.
Then everything should be under control.
Yes. Okay, guys. Osteoporosis cage match. Betty versus Linda.
I don't remember which one we hated. Was it Linda? Was Linda the one that we hated, Rich? Do you remember?
I did get them both confused. They both sucked.
They both sucked.
I think Betty was the one that almost knocked over the houseplant. She almost ran into it. Veering dangerously off.
That's right. That's right. She's the one that looked like Jackie Mason.
It's okay, they're both dead now.
That's right. Oh yeah, for those asking, yes, Divine has passed away.
Oh yeah, Divine actually passed away the night before. Well, I should say Glenn, because Glenn Milstead is his real name, and he was trying to branch out and do less roles in drag. He was cast as an uncle on Married with Children, and he died the night before he was supposed to start shooting. He was going to become a regular, like a recurring character on it.
Sure.
So, yeah.
He got out of the drag and was a male actor.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he was trying to branch out and do more different things, and that was a big break for him, and then he died from just being too overweight.
Oh, that's too bad.
It's very sad.
Oh, thank you, Octo J. Everyone asks me what the specs are for Rich's new PC, and I have no idea. But Octo J just said what they are. I'm actually going to copy that.
To see you have it?
Okay, I've copied it. I'm going to put it in a text file over here. Put it in a note.
4 gigahertz i7. It's the EVGA... GeForce 970 graphics card, Asus Z97 motherboard.
It's super hyper ultra RAM. I remember that.
8 megabytes worth of Kingston Hyper X RAM.
Yeah. Calibrated your scanner to alert you to their presence. I know. Yeah. If anyone who doesn't know computer parts just saw what Octo J typed as Rich's PC, you would think that he was randomly mashing the keyboard. None of it makes any sense.
So I gotta crouch through here.
Oh, Rich, apparently you can extend your field of view, by the way. Oh my god, you're fighting laser dinosaurs?
Yes.
What the fuck? That's awesome!
Yeah, they're great looking.
I'm trying to sneak past them now because I don't have any weapons.
Sure.
Assuming at some point I will be able to shoot laser dinosaurs.
Oh my god, I bet you can ride a laser dinosaur. This is so awesome. Why is this game like a joke? This is just cool.
Yeah, this is neat.
There's lots of jokes in here. I'm kind of got the sounds kind of low and I'm half paying attention.
Sure,
so.
Oh, I'm sorry, they're not dinosaurs. They're dragons. Blood dragons.
Blood dragons, yeah.
Oh man, that's awesome.
I'm actually looking forward to going home later and fine-tuning the controls and really, really, honestly getting into this game.
Sure, they might technically be blood dragons, but they look like laser dinosaurs. So I stand by my original.
I'm gonna call them Tron dragons.
Ooh.
No, fuck that. Fuck the original score. It's all about the Daft Punk score.
I love the Daft Punk score, but I do love the classic Tron theme too.
Mm.
Why can't there be room in your heart for two things?
Not in my heart. Daft Punk is too overpowering. There's no room.
The nerd's heart is a very small thing. Yes. with limited capacity, isn't it?
Yep. Right, Lloyd Beats, I know it's not a joke, it's a stylistic mod for Far Cry 3. I get that, but like everything about this is a little jokey. But yeah. It just looks neat. Like I'm not dissing Blood Dragon. It was just a greater thing of like they're kind of getting away with this style because they're doing it slightly tongue in cheek.
Yeah.
But I think they could have just done it normal.
Yeah.
And not the fucking cheek have it still be good. I ain't dissing, yo. Just saying I like it. I got you hooked on the FTL score. Good.
It's I saw this question earlier. I think it might have been aimed at me, but we can all answer it. Favorite movie score.
Oh man.
I don't know.
There you go. There's your answer.
All around, individual track.
Let's just say overall score. That enhances the movie and makes it great. Mine's Punch Drunk Love. John Bryan's score for Punch Drunk Love is the most amazing thing, and it fits that movie perfectly.
Yeah.
Movie with the most underrated score?
What's that?
Ghostbusters. Nobody talks about the score.
That is a good score.
But it's
just
perfect. And I'm not talking about the theme song. I'm talking about the score.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. You know, they're just the.
Yeah, the movie's got a good score. Who does it? Do you know? I don't even know.
Barry Goldsmith?
I don't know. Someone will tell us. I almost feel bad that I don't know, but I don't.
Elmer Bernstein?
Okay, that sounds right.
Alright.
What the fuck?
The Elmer Bernstein. Elmer Bernstein, yes. Magnificent.
Krieger 783. Who gives John Carpenter's The Thing score shit? That's a great score. All John Carpenter scores are great.
Right?
Interesting.
Oh man, he did everything. He did this.
Elmer, he's done a ton of stuff.
Yeah, that's great. I mean, obviously we've talked about Tron Legacy. It's an amazing score.
Yes.
Yeah.
And it's tough where it's like, yeah, talking about Ghostbusters, that complements the movie so well.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, like, Ghostbusters is a score that I wouldn't just listen to on its own.
Yeah,
that's true.
But it's a perfect complement to the movie, whereas something like Tron Legacy I listen to just on itself.
I think a lot of people like the score more than they like the movie.
I think I've mentioned this before, the Royal Tenenbaums score.
Oh yeah, Mark Mothersbaugh. That's a good score.
Wait, really amazing.
Phil, what am I supposed to do? I need to pay more attention to
the game. It also has like a good soundtrack, like the mm-hmm. the songs
they use.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
But the original Mark Mothersbaugh score is fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
Punch Drunk Love is an amazing atmospheric.
It makes. I mean, it's a great movie, but that score really not only. Works as a score, like it enhances the movie. It's you can't imagine the movie without it.
Oh. I'm sorry, Jack.
Is that the same person?
Thank you for We appreciate the subscription. I don't know if you're the same person or just someone else making a joke. Either way, we appreciate the support. And also thank you to those who point out that I missed a subscriber. Rich, did you hear what the fuck?
I've got the headphones half on. I probably missed it. I'm sorry.
How do you miss yourself screaming what the fuck?
This is your job now, Rich.
Social Network's a good score.
That's,
Trent Reznor.
Trent Reznor.
And Atticus Ross? I always want to say Atticus Finch, but I know that's not right.
I was going to say the same thing.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, really. Any, I was thinking. Mark Mothersbaugh got me thinking. Like he did Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs. He did the Lego Movie score. Like,
oh, I didn't know that.
He has really interesting music.
I think the first. I could be wrong. But I think the first score he did was for Wes Anderson. Like, I think he just did a couple Wes Anderson movies, and then other people liked it, and so he started doing other scores, I think.
Well, perhaps the first thing he did was Rugrats.
Oh, did he do the opening credits theme for that? Oh, okay. I might be completely wrong, then.
Oh, I can't go through there.
Oh, that makes sense. I didn't know that, but now I'm hearing it in my head. I'm like, oh yeah, I can totally see that as Mark Mothersbaugh.
Oh sure. Well, and you know, Royal Tenenbaums was orchestral.
Yeah.
You know, like very not Mark Mothersbaugh, but beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Just beautiful. Mm. Mark Mothersbaugh in general.
The piece of music that I always love from that movie is the there's that shot during the long take where it's panning across everybody, like the aftermath during after the wedding sequence.
Yeah.
And it shows Royal buying the dog, and then he goes over to Ben Stiller and is talking with him, and Ben Stiller's like, we've had a rough year. That long take and the music that's playing during that part is so great.
Yeah.
That's a good movie all around.
It is. Mm-hmm. That's my favorite Wes Anderson.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Game needs a leaning key.
It needs a lean key?
It does. I'm going to try it.
Okay. Do it.
It's not letting me do the stealth kill?
Do you have a knife?
I must not have anything. Oh, this is awful.
You just gotta sneak past him. So yeah, scores. They're great. They're great when they're great.
Climb in?
And sometimes they're just nice little pieces.
Oh, a bow and arrow.
Oh, there you go. Oh, a laser bow and arrow.
Oh, they saw me.
Holy shit.
We have, Akazi, we've made no progress on the prereq Steam account.
I did register a name.
Oh, okay. Rich, we've made some progress on the prereq Steam account, which is registered a name. We're working on. Can you pick up your arrows now?
That
would be awesome. Oh, nope.
Wait, this guy up there.
Okay.
I like the bow and arrow.
Oh, they're saying you can throw the hearts.
How do you do that? What does that do?
Two really good questions.
Objective. Use cyborg vision to tag hostiles in the base from the overlook.
Alright, how do you do that, and what does it do? Oh, they're saying press G to throw the hearts. And they attract the blood dragons.
Oh,
nice.
Those happen to be my two.
That would be awesome. And for the person who asked, no, we attempted the edited Let's Play. We attempted.
Didn't work out.
And I started cutting it together, and you know, our bits weren't that good, and then like they were too far in between, and then if you cut one part of the bit, you have to cut it all. And yeah, it just didn't work out. Oh, what happened?
I had died.
Oh.
Oh. Which doesn't surprise me at all.
So, it didn't work out at all. We have been talking casually. I had a lot of fun, and I hope Rich had too. I had a lot of fun with the Space Quest.
Yo, yeah.
I had a ton of fun with Space Quest, but that was a game where I really had to pay attention, and of course, Rich knew the game, and so he couldn't really talk to me about the game because, like, he couldn't help me figure out, so that was really disappointing. And so we were thinking about doing a live stream of an adventure game where
we haven't played it. Where we, either of us.
Where we either of us haven't played it, but then we wouldn't get a lot of interaction with you, the chat, and so maybe it could be a special, like another night in which we kind of not turn off the chat. But
I think we can do the occasional stream that's not quite as interactive as normal.
Yeah.
That's fine.
Well, and that's why it would be like a bonus, is all I'm saying. Where we don't want to ignore you, chat. I look at the microphone when I'm talking to you. We don't want to.
Well, that's your portal into the chat. That's how they hear you, is through the microphone.
So, we want to do Broken Age, but we want to wait until both parts are out.
What's Broken Age?
Broken Age is an adventure game made by people who used to make nothing but adventure games, but then they fell out of...
You like the point-and-clicky ones. I mean, the texty ones.
I do like the texty ones, yeah.
You like the text-only one. Zork, as I've heard, is...
I'll finish answering your question.
Oh, I'm sorry. No, finish answering your question. I'm a jerk, whatever.
I don't even remember my question anymore.
Broken Age.
Yeah.
So these people used to make nothing but text adventure games.
Okay.
Or point-and-click adventure games. They used to make nothing but point-and-click adventure games, but then they fell out of fashion. Point-and-click adventure games.
Yeah.
So they wanted to make a new one. They made a Kickstarter, and it was a huge Kickstarter. One of the biggest Kickstarters I've ever seen.
Oh, wow.
For a new point-and-click adventure game, and they... But they somehow ran out of money, and so they're releasing it in halves.
Okay.
Hoping that sales from the first one will then help them finish the second one. There's a little dubiousness.
Yeah.
But in any case, I am a Kickstarter backer of the Double Fine Adventure game, Broken Age. But we're going to wait until the entire thing is out and then play it.
Yeah.
So. So now, Rich, what would you like to talk about?
Well, now I'm in the middle of a firefight. The only old Sierra game I haven't played. Just thinking about adventure games we could stream together.
Sure.
The second Leisure Suit Larry.
Okay.
Might be the only classic Sierra adventure game that's not point and click.
Okay.
That I haven't played.
Oh, okay.
If you don't mind trying the point and click adventures.
Yeah, we can try them.
I played it, but I don't think I'm going to remember literally anything about it. The Star Trek 25th anniversary game.
Okay.
Which also has a sequel, also haven't played, called Judgment Rites.
Okay.
And then there's a next-gen adventure game called The Final Unity.
Yeah.
And I think all of them have a version of that game with voice acting from the original cast.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
That's fun.
Yeah.
We can do those. We can do point and click. No, you know, the frog fraction.
I'm not as fond of point and click myself.
Oh, gotcha.
But whatever.
Yeah, we can do it.
And Zork, I believe, is like free to play these days.
Oh, okay. Cool.
Yeah.
That's cool. Yeah. We can give it a try. We can give them tries.
Public domain. That's what I'm looking for.
Public domain.
On Zork.
Yeah.
Is what I've heard.
Okay. And that's the only text.
That's only text. That's hardcore.
Yeah, so there's a lot we're looking into, but yeah, so there's this huge Kickstarter, and the guy who made it quite possibly got a little too big with his ambitions for the game.
Okay.
And the reviews have not been stellar for the first part. And
Nobody ever accused Tim Schafer of being smart with money.
That's the real thing. He's an artist. He's an artist. He's not a business person. yeah. But I'll tell you, as a backer, part of the subscription tier that I was on, I got a t-shirt, which is a great t-shirt. I got a poster, but I also, they've been making behind-the-scenes featurettes.
Oh, okay.
Like a documentary about the creative process of making the game.
Oh, that's neat.
And that's
I like that kind of stuff, so. Yeah. Now, for video games, I couldn't care less, but... Well, it's, in general,
it's still neat.
You know, like, they talk about like the story they want to tell, how they create the characters. They like follow the artists back home and like have the artists talk about like what their inspirations are. It's been a super fantastic behind the scenes series.
So. Oh, okay.
That's been great.
Nice.
Yeah.
I don't. So what you're saying is they've done a good job of fulfilling their Kickstarter obligations.
Except for the game.
Except for the game.
Because we've only had the first half of the game.
Okay.
But yeah, everything else, they've been doing fine.
These guys just scientists? Don't seem to be harmful.
They have guns.
They're not shooting at me, though.
Are they on your team?
They must be.
Oh, great. There you go, then. Oh, yeah.
What the fuck?
Moral Radical says, I lost all my money to Harry Knowles.
You got scammed by that hack.
We warned you. We have a what the fuck, Jack.
Do we have a... We do, Apex Casket. Thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it.
Oh, I saw someone, Jack, favorite podcast. Do you listen to a lot? You listen to podcasts, right?
I used to.
Not anymore?
I don't anymore.
No? Why not?
No time.
No? Okay.
And, you know, so much of my time is editing, and you have to listen to what the damn people are saying.
That's true. That's true.
If I get into a rhythm where it's like I'm doing a lot of After Effects work, then I can pick up some podcasts.
Oh, okay.
I really like... I used to listen to Nerdist.
Well, they have a bunch of podcasts, right? Isn't that like a whole network of stuff? Yeah. I don't know anything about it, but...
Just the main one I used to subscribe to, and I enjoy
it. Oh, okay.
Mostly because he gives a good interview. CGP Grey has a podcast now, and it's great. Hello Internet is what it's called. And everyone should know that I'm a big fan of him. He's a YouTuber. He makes... educational videos.
Right. Oh yeah, I remember. Weren't you wearing a shirt in one of our videos, and then he was like, "Hey, that's my shirt."
Yep. He's a fan of Red Letter Media, as it turns out. So he was very excited to see his shirt in a Red Letter Media video. So he does a podcast called Hello Internet, which is just fantastic.
Okay. Oh.
We're not
sure. CGP Greg.
Okay.
Or GCP Greg. Oh, I might mix.
Oh,
I might get it mixed up.
You asshole.
Oh my god, I totally. Now I need to check. What is it?
I thought it was CGP.
It might be. I want to say it's CGP, but, you know, my brain.
I have a handful of podcasts I listen to. I listen to them when I'm running. That's my me time. I just put in my earbuds, and I run for like an hour and a half and listen to podcasts. It's great. There's my favorite is, it's called Killer POV. It's a horror podcast.
All
right. Done by a group of horror journalists. And they're all very, very good. They have a nice dynamic, and I always, like, I think when people think of horror fans, they think of, like, people you'd see at conventions that are wearing, like, heavy metal shirts, and they're all, you know, larger men with big burly beards, but no, there's, but there's other type of horror fans out there, and it's the three that are hosting the show, and they're good.
Yeah.
I also listen to The Projection Booth, which is another film one.
Oh, cool.
I'm actually going to be on The Projection Booth because I know those guys.
Oh, nice.
February, because they plan their episodes out that far in advance for some reason.
I mean, that's great.
Who is this?
It's a podcast called The Projection Booth.
Okay.
It's a movie podcast.
Are you going to Skype in? Or?
We're going to talk about the movie Trancers with Tim Thomerson. I can't wait. I love that movie.
Ah, that's great. If anyone has read the Freakonomics books.
Oh, yeah, I remember you telling me about this.
They're fantastic books. Really, really interesting reads. They do a podcast, the Freakonomics podcast. And always really interesting stuff. I tried listening to, like, movie podcasts. I don't know, I haven't found any ones that I enjoyed. I hear really great things about How Did This Get Made?
How did This Get Made is entertaining. I listened to that one. They're a little too hyper for me, where it's like they're clearly exaggerating their frustration or confusion by the movies.
Okay.
And that can get a little tiring, but it depends on the movie they're talking about. It can be funny.
Okay. I really enjoy Paul Scheer as a comedian.
Yeah. So. Yeah, he kind of holds the show together. Jason Mantzoukas, is that how you pronounce his name?
Sure, why not?
Jason Mantzoukas?
Yeah. Yeah, he's on it.
Oh, good.
He's the one that exaggerates a little too much for my taste, but... But he can be funny, too.
Okay. But he can be funny, I guess.
I guess. He's
or whatever.
Right. He's all right. Nah.
Oh, yeah.
Everything's just okay.
It's true. There's a local podcast that I listen to every once in a while. The guy from... formerly from AV Club. You know, the section... For anyone who used to get The Onion.
Remember when The Onion was a publication?
Remember when The Onion was a paper that you could get at your local coffee shop? They had a local section called the AV Club that would cover local things, and the guy who did it for Milwaukee has a weekly thing with a local college radio station where they just talk about general Milwaukee things. And
is that Matt Wilds, or is it a different guy? Oh, it is him. Okay.
Matt Wild, a guy from a different local paper, The Shepherd Express, and a guy from WMSE, do a weekly, Milwaukee, we're just going to chat about shit. And now I might forget what it's called. He has a new website now. It's called the Milwaukee Record.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I've seen that.
And it basically is what the AV Club used to be.
Yeah.
But only for Milwaukee. I'm going to forget what the name of their...
Oh, I know that. Milwaukee Record... did some article recently where they mentioned us.
Oh.
Rather than, I think it was what was the article? I know we tweeted about it. I can't remember anything anymore. No, what is happening? Can't. Let me find it.
Yeah. Bird Jack fuck? What?
You want Jack to fuck? What?
Oh no, Selectimo just typed Jack. And then fuck.
Okay.
Alright.
I hope I don't have to collect.
What was that Milwaukee Record thing? Oh, 8 pop culture institutions with Milwaukee ties.
Oh, okay.
So they talk about Harley Davidson and I think Laverne and Shirley and stuff like that.
Yeah. Well, there you go.
That's it.
There you go. No, but they, you know, they're interesting guys and, you know, just pop culture people. And so
yeah.
I like listening to them. I can't remember the name of their show, unfortunately. Yeah. Oh, how come you guys don't have Milwaukee accents?
Well, Rich and I, neither of us are from Milwaukee.
So there you go.
So there's that.
And what you might be thinking of is a northern Wisconsin accent, the Fargo...
Yeah, or like a Minnesota accent, yeah.
Or like a Uper accent is what we call it.
Yeah, yeah.
If you are from the Upper Peninsula, which is not part of Wisconsin, it's actually part of Michigan.
Yeah.
But if you live in the UP, then you got the, oh, dare you know, don't you know.
The best is I remember when Fargo came out and hearing people complaining about the stereotypes in that movie, and they're like, we don't talk like that. It's like, you sound just like the movie.
Yeah. Yeah. So, I mean, this is just how we talk.
Yeah.
I apologize for our lack of hilariously annoying accent.
Lucky as strikes, yeah. Oh yeah, is it reasonable? That's something from Fargo I quote all the time. Madden, you're such a super lady. Fargo is the best. Fargo is a perfect movie. I love that movie.
I'm gonna go ahead and agree with you.
Yes, there's not a single flaw in that entire movie.
Is that true? Don Gately, I have an IMDb page. Great.
Yeah, you're on IMDb because Feeding Frenzy, and okay. I think you're listed for Space Cop already, even though it's not. Yeah, everybody does at this point.
Thank you.
That's what happens when you make stuff. Yeah. When you make movies.
Yeah. So thank you to any of you who added stuff to IMDb for me.
Mm.
I appreciate it.
Oh, that's right. Aren't you listed as something weird for the High Five Hollywood video? Like, where it's not the proper credit? I seem to remember this.
Hold on. I have a computer right here. I'm going to Google me, guys. It's going to be awesome. Mostly pornos, you're right, on my IMDb. I don't come up as a suggestion when I type my name into the search bar, so I'm not that big yet. Oh, wow. There's a lot of stuff in here. Previously recorded on here, that's great.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Half in the Bag, Feeding...
Is Best of the Worst? I don't think Best of the Worst is on IMDb, but Half in the Bag I know is.
Half in the Bag, recorded Pork in Space... All secondary activities reward. Oh yeah, that's right. Best of the Worst. Yeah, Best of the Worst is here. I'm credited as self for Best of the Worst.
Oh, okay.
So there you go. When you are running supplies, that's right. I'm credited as a writer for High Five.
That's funny.
Which I suppose is technically true.
I guess. Okay.
But you know, he didn't write anything down. Technically true.
Yeah.
That's fine. Oh, that's great. That's super fun. Oh, my space cadets. As Ferk.
Is that on there?
I got word that they're showing Space Cadets. Space Cadets is the movie that I acted in for a couple UWM college kids as a project they were doing.
Mm-hmm.
I can either see it at the Beloit International Film Festival.
Ah, which is actually becoming a bigger festival.
Which is becoming a bit of a bigger
festival. Even though Beloit's the worst town ever.
It's also playing in a festival in India.
Oh, really?
So either one.
Okay. So. That's funny.
Yeah.
Have you ever been to Beloit?
I've never been to that. No, I've never been to Beloit. Apologize.
No, that's a good thing.
I mean, you know, fine. Yeah, that's a compact desk pro. Like, did I write real life Angry Birds? Like, no. You don't write stuff like that down. You just do it.
I didn't even give myself a writing credit for Pork in Space, even though I did write, like, I wrote an outline. Yeah, I knew what all the scenes were going to be, but I didn't write dialogue or anything.
Uh-huh.
But I put it as conceived and directed by Jay Bowman. I didn't put written by.
Okay.
Because I felt weird when something was that, like, collaborative, even though I came up with the basic, you know, scene structure.
I think that's a proper way to credit yourself.
Yeah. I didn't know how to do it, but I didn't want to just say written by.
Yeah. Oh, Lloyd Beats, that is a good and important question. Is Rich's "Oh my God" a reference to Troll 2, or did he say that prior?
No, that's prior. That's back from the old days.
Yeah, that's from old movies.
Yeah.
I doubt you remember where it originated from, though, at this point, do you?
Just being goofy and yelling. I don't know.
But not like, there wasn't like one specific short that it started with?
If there is, I don't remember.
Okay. I know what's wrong with your face started with one of the old shorts, right?
What's wrong with your face? I also think that... Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
I don't remember any of the shit I did when I was a kid.
I know Mike has mentioned that.
I was thinking Al My Grind. I know
Al My Grind's been around for a while.
That actually kind of started with The Simpsons, because Homer's on the roller coaster, and he says, "Al My Heart."
He
has a bad heart, and he still went on the roller coaster.
Oh, my heart.
Oh, my heart. And I know Oh, My Groin evolved out of that.
Okay.
As far as what's wrong with your face,
I know Mike had said it started in one of the shorts, but it evolved into What's Wrong With Your Face. Mm-hmm. When it started, it was something different. It was like, your face, what's wrong with it? And it's, like, warped over time.
Oh.
Something like that.
Sure. Are those on any of the collections, like the old, your old movies?
I don't think the features.
No. Those would have to be completely re-edited because because of music issues.
Oh, sure.
So.
Yeah, but oh my god! I think it's not. I don't know if there's any one specific thing, or that's just me yelling.
Yeah, it's just me yelling.
And oh my god, just happens to come out. Oh my god! Same as what the fuck?
Oh my god, we have a subscriber? Is that Rich yelling.
What? Yeah, what was just me thinking, saying what was funny?
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, because it is.
Yeah. It is. Yeah. What?
I think we put it on the outtakes for Gorilla Interrupted, the DVD. Because mm-hmm. do you remember when we shot that, Rich, and we shot extra what's?
Extra what's.
Yeah, we there's
a trailer that was nothing but us saying.
Yeah, we never made the trailer, but I did put all the what's in the outtake reel on the DVD. We just shot what's that had nothing to do with the scene, just to have extra what's. What?
What?
You're right, Beyond Infinite. Rich is a verbal artist. A cunning linguist.
I've always said that.
It's true. It's all true.
I like this game, but I think I like it enough that I want to play it more on my own.
Oh,
when I can
okay,
fully
sure.
concentrate on it.
Sure.
I think we got an hour and a half. I think that's decent. Right?
Okay. Sure. Yeah, I mean, fought, yeah. Are we that much in already?
It's 9. We started at 7:30.
Oh my
right God. On time with no technical problems.
Oh, my God. You're right. Usually we start so much later because we're right with technical problems. Yeah, no, if you want, I mean, we can take a little break. Run a commercial.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
Okay, that sounds like a plan.
Yeah, but I like it. I want to hear Michael Biehn dialogue,
yeah.
Like, properly, without kind of half one ear falling
sure.
off listening to you guys.
Sure, sure. Oh, guys.
A lot of little funny bits that I'm kind of missing.
They want us to play Don't Shit Your Pants.
I won't play.
Is that a text-based game?
I believe yes. That is
yes.
A text-based
okay.
game.
I think I saw some people typing that in the chat the other day.
Rich,
but I didn't know if they were just fucking around or
Rich
not because you were playing a text-based
game.
Another game
that he wants to put on is like,
well, what do you want? Do you want to play?
We'll play another real game and then maybe we'll close out.
How long is Don't Shit Your Pants chat?
That's the real question. Be honest with us. How long is it for realsies?
We know when you're lying.
We know, we do. We're like Santa Claus. We're not real. I don't even know if that'll pick up on the microphones. They're saying play FTL. Don't Shit Your Pants takes 5 minutes, 5-10 minutes.
So.
5-10 minutes, okay.
5-10-15 minutes in that range somewhere.
Yeah. About 9 inches. That's really fun. It's a text adventure. Listen, FTL will happen again. We have to take breaks from FTL. Because if we didn't, by the way, this would be an entirely FTL / Binding of Isaac dedicated stream.
XCOM. Don't forget XCOM.
With a little XCOM thrown in for variety.
A lot of XCOM when I'm streaming.
Yeah. So we do our best to vary it up for you guys, or else we would play FTL every single week.
Mm.
Twice a week.
Alright.
So, in any case, we're going to take a break. This is a thing that's going to happen. Alright, so Rich.
Yes.
What you need to do to take a break. Over here.
Okay.
Because we're also teaching.
I need to get out of this thing here.
You need to get out of this thing. Head back over to Open Broadcaster.
Wiki Wars.
I loved Wiki Wars. we're gonna play that again. Just because I enjoy that game.
All right, what do I click on for the ad?
Okay, well, so first you do is you mute the microphone. So.